Our team has been developing a 3D printed model for clinical procedures training. As clinical educators, we train both medical and veterinary students in basic and advanced clinical procedures, such as bronchoscopy, which involves placing a flexible endoscope into the airway. This procedure must be completed in a timely manner for the safety of the patient, who's often in a critical state. Currently, students gain most of their clinical training on the job. This creates a stressful learning environment and limits the opportunity for students to develop the skills they require to become competent. Other training options currently used include using dried-out lungs from cadavers or virtual reality trainers, which are great but expensive.
We have produced a 3D printed airway model from a CT scan of a dog's lungs. The advantages of our model over other current training methods are that students can develop and practice bronchoscopy skills with direct real-time feedback from mentors in a safe learning environment. They can practice regularly and even make mistakes with no risk to patients. These videos are from a patient on the left and from our model on the right. As you can see, the model is very realistic. Our main considerations for the model were that the anatomy was accurate and realistic, replicates the bronchoscopy procedure, and that it would not damage the scope. We thought the main users of our model would be university teachers or continuing education providers running practical endoscopy workshops.
Taking the TRAM, we interviewed people in our main target groups, including students, educators, NC providers, as well as industry partners. We expanded our interview list to include endoscopy manufacturers, hospital administrators, and other companies selling training models. This interview provided valuable information that confirmed that there is a gap in the market for a model like ours. Students like the realism of the model and the ability to practice repeatedly at their own pace in their own time. Educators commented on the ability to structure learning objectives and do competency assessments. We also identified our model could be used for learning other clinical procedures. We listened and incorporated new ideas about business models, such as renting rather than purchasing the model. Through the interviews and questioning of our value proposition, we had confirmation from many different sources that our idea would provide a missing link in training for clinical procedures. We identified our primary customer group to be continuing education providers. The interview also provided some awareness of potential future hurdles, such as scale-up production and distribution logistics.
Our next steps are to use the information gained through TRAM to develop a business plan and secure funding to progress the commercialization of our research. Based on feedback, we've developed new model prototypes and have other models under development for other high-risk clinical procedures like epidural injections. We'd like to thank Andrew and Bonnie for their mentorship in running an excellent program, and also to the other TRAM teams for their input and support. At this stage, we'd welcome any input and feedback, and specifically if you or someone you know is interested in helping us develop our training models, please feel free to get in touch. We're also keen to expand our team to include someone with business or marketing experience as we progress to the next stages. Thank you very much.